Hey, Jack, welcome back to
the
track.
Hey, Jake, how are you?
So each one of these cars behind you has a different superpower. Each one is a different drivetrain.
Drivetrain, what's that?
So a drivetrain is how you get the power from the engine to the wheels.
And so what are the differences between these superpowers?
We have a car here that's front-wheel drive, one with rear-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, and a 4x4 four-wheel drive system. The first one is front-wheel drive, and that's kind of the most common one, and that's the best blend of fuel economy and traction.
Jake says it gets better fuel economy because it's lighter, since it doesn't need a drive shaft and other components to power the rear wheels. And it gets better traction because the engine weight is over the drive wheels.
Jake, out of all these cars, I got my eye on this blue one.
Well, you got some great taste. That's definitely the sportiest one. But each one of these superpowers, they have a different advantage. In fact, the 4x4, you can actually take that up a rock hill and go off-roading with it. Before we do that, I'm gonna take you the blue one, we're gonna take it around the skid pad.
Oh, yeah!
A skid pad is a big circle of track, like this one here, and it's used to evaluate how well a car can grip while turning.
Now, you know, most cars are front-wheel drive, and that works great, but if you really want something performance-oriented, well, rear-wheel drive is where it's at.
So what exactly is rear-wheel drive?
That means all the power is going to the rear wheels.
Well, the front wheels are going to steer the car in the direction you want to go.
What you're going to notice is, well, when I go around the corner and I give a little gas.
So what's happening is power to the rear wheels is helping us accelerate and gives me more control in the corners, which makes the car handle better in tight turns like this. But since this drivetrain pushes the car rather than pulls it, it can be harder to maneuver in slippery conditions.
Well, what you think?
Not bad, Jake. I really like the handling of this car.
Well, there's certainly a reason why most sports cars and race cars are rear-wheel drive.
Because they have an advantage when it comes to accelerating and handling. But that's not going to be a top priority for everyday driving. We also have an all-wheel drive vehicle. Now, this is real common in SUVs and can send power to each individual wheel. This is great for getting your car moving on a slick surface, like snow or ice. But one mistake people make is they think that all-wheel drive also means you're going to have superior handling and stopping capabilities in those slippery situations, which is not the case. For that, a good set of winter tires is your best bet.
Next up, four-wheel drive.
Four-wheel drive and all-wheel drive, it sounds a lot alike, but here's what the difference is. I could actually take this into this low range gearing. That's gonna enable me to go down these really steep hills and go up the hills. You can't do that with all wheel drive. You can't do that with most luxury cars or SUVs.
2H is two wheel drive, what most cars have. It works for most normal driving. 4H is four wheel drive, high gear with maximum traction for snow and dirt. 4L is four-wheel drive low gear for going up and down steep hills.
You know, it's all about having the right tool for the job. So I actually have my foot off the brake pedal.
So this is the car doing it automatically?
This is the car in the low range holding my speed so I can go down here safely.
Like if you almost had the brake on.
It's almost like that, but it's making sure I'm not locking up the tires, I'm not locking up the brakes. It's really designed for this.
This is what four-wheel drive is.
Four-wheel drive with a low-range gearing. And I'm actually in gear one. You ready?
Yeah, let's do it. So take me through what the car is doing.
So the car is trying to put the power down and using all four wheels to try to pull this truck up this hill. And it's doing a pretty good job of it. You cannot do this with just most little SUVs or...
The rear-wheel drive won't work on this.
Absolutely not. And you gotta know what you're doing. Don't try this at home, for sure.
Wow, that was fun, Jake.
So, after hearing about all these different drivetrains, which superpower would you choose?
Well, the rear-wheel drive is awesome, but I don't go on a racetrack quite often. I like the four-wheel drive, too, but I don't go up rock hills
most often.
Jake says since front-wheel drive is fuel-efficient and handles well in bad weather, it's the best choice for me.
That's why we test these things, to try to give that information so the consumers can make the right choices. Since we're here, and we've got a rock hill, you want to try driving it?
Jake, you read my mind. Okay, I'm going up the mountain!
Slow and steady is the way to do this.
Let that
four-wheel drive system and that low-range gearing do its stuff.
I can feel the power.
Yeah. Do you feel it? Found some grip. Come on, you can do it. You got it. You got it.
Nice job.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for the ride, Jake.